Reddit. What's the time you saw an asshole kid get what they deserve? I was working at a Pizza Hut at the time. Some kid around age 10 or so went into the men's restroom and shit in the urinal, then proceeded to smear it all over the goddamn place. We knew it was the kid due to it not being very busy that day, and a coworker spotted the mess right after the kid left the bathroom. We weren't sure what to do, but the manager decided to tell the parents. The father was pissed. He made the boy clean it up. He stood over him yelling at him and made him clean it all. The boy was crying, but you know, fuck that kid. He was old enough to know you don't do that shit. He wasn't mentally impaired. He was just an ass. We were all glad the dad stepped up. Otherwise we would have had to clean it. TL. Drive. 10 years old brat smeared his own shit all over a Pizza Hut. His father made him clean it up. I was driving a fire truck back from an all-night fire about 7 a.m. This truck's diesel mixture was a bit rich, so if you sat for a while and gunned it, you might get smoke from the exhaust. As I approached a highway from the residential street I was on, there were six middle school kids waiting for the school bus on the corner. As some kids do, they stand or walk in the street and refuse to move four cars. As I came to the intersection, one little shit looks at me smugly and does not move, causing me to have to go into the oncoming lane at the intersection. I patiently waited until I could make my turn onto the highway, then gunned the shit out of the fire truck's diesel engine, causing a thick blob of black thick smoke to come out the exhaust, which was mid-truck pointed right at the kids. They were coated in thick oily diesel fumes, especially Mr. Smug Shit, and last I saw they were halfway down the block on the sidewalk running with me on the road spewing smoke after them. Mr. Smug looked at me with terror in his little half-developed mind. Our neighbors have 5 kids. They're all brats, but the middle child, a boy, is the worst. He was in front of his house one day while I was outside doing some landscaping in my front yard. A shiny new red pickup truck drove by, then slammed on the brakes and started backing up. It stopped in front of the brat's house. I heard the lady in the passenger seat yell, "Did you just throw a rock at our car?" Of course the boy denied it and started making up some ridiculous excuse, like he always does when people catch him making mischief. The woman cut him off and told him to go get his mom. Apparently the woman in the truck was from the neighborhood and was also fed up with their kids and their nonsense. The mom finally came out holding the youngest brat, and the woman in the truck proceeded to give her the kind of verbal beatdown that the mom should have been giving her own kid all along. Watching that mom stand there and listen to some stranger rightfully criticize her parenting for 10 minutes straight was gratifying. The only thing better was watching the brat squirm the whole time. There was a kid in high school that was trying to rob an ice cream truck. The driver accidentally ran him over and broke both of his legs. I once saw a kid terrorizing a dog at a park. The dog was tied to a pole and the kid was chasing the dog around on his bike. The owner came back and started yelling at the kid. As the kid rode off, he popped a wheelie and the front wheel of his bike popped off midair and he did a face plant in the parking lot. I felt pretty bad for laughing, but couldn't help it. It was so unexpected. Worked in a pet store when I was in high school, and we had a real issue with this particular family letting their kids act like dick bags all over the store. One fateful day, asshole family walks in, and dick bag daughter goes right to the puppy room. Kids can't hold dogs without a parent, and no one picks up a pup unless we are the ones to get them out of their little runs for them. Welp, little Mrs. Swipe reaches in and grabs a pup by the leg and tried to pull it toward the wall of the run so she can lift it out. I see this on my CC monitor by the register and run over to stop her from hurting this puppy. By the time I get in, she has hoisted this dog up by one leg and nearly has him over the wall of the run. Mom and dad are standing right there, not doing shit, when I walk in. Before I can get a word out, shitty daughter sees me and drops the puppy back into the run and turns around like nothing happened. I yell at the girl and her parents obviously get defensive, and I offer to play back the tape of their daughter hauling a puppy up by its leg then dropping it 4 feet onto a tile floor. I tell them they need to go, and of course they refuse. As I go back up front to inform the manager, I notice little Miss Fuckwit poking her fingers into the feeder rat cage while shaking it. The rat in that cage was a jumbo feeder and was separated from the other feeders because she had just had a litter of pups. Now, rat moms are good moms. They will protect their babies, unlike mice who give zero fucks about their progeny. This is important. Dickhole daughter has her finger in the cage, and is banging on the opposite side when karma strikes. Mama rat is not having any of this shit and runs right up to this girl's soft pink finger and bites down hard on the little shit's finger. All hell breaks loose, because mama rat isn't letting go and rat bites blow. Parents freak, manager tries to calm the situation, and I get a band-aid and alcohol for little fuckwit, so she stops bleeding all over the floor. In the end, asshole family isn't banned from the store, boo, but stops coming soon after, because idiot mom insists that the giant blue and gold macaw is friendly even though he isn't, and gets her ear ripped up a good one. In the end, rat mom and babies get promoted to pet rats instead of feeders for their brave part in helping exact vengeance of dickhead families with demon spawn. The blue and gold macaw was also rewarded for his part with many french fries. TL, Doctor, Rat, and Macaw avenge their puppy brethren from the bullshittery that is helicopter parents and their shitty children. I once saw a kid run up to a man and kick him square in the balls. The man immediately dropped to his knees, then pulled a gun from his waistline, and aimed it at the kid to scare him off. I'm not one to say that anyone deserves one thing or another, but I lived in a fairly bad neighborhood at the time, so maybe that kid learned a lesson about what might happen if you fuck with someone. Used to coach youth lacrosse in Georgia. Volunteer hours through my college team. Had a kid whose name, I shit you not, was Harsh. Anyways, I had the elementary school age kids for practice one night with Harsh. He went through a drill with a weaker kid who ended up costing his team the point. They get to the end of the line for the drill and Harsh, a fifth grader, hits this second grader in the helmet with his stick. I stop the practice, line all the kids up, and make them do 30 yard down and back sprints. I make Harsh call out every sprint, and every kid has to call out thank you Harsh instead of whatever number sprint they were on. After 10 of them, I restarted the practice. The other kids beat him to a pulp. Beat the fuck out of him. It was awesome. TL, Dr. Kid was a dick, so I punished his teammates and they, in turn, beat his ass. The little jerk off that pushed my daughter down and stole her pinwheel toy from her at the park completely biffed it into the slide running away. I chuckled. I won't even pretend like I didn't. Kid was there unsupervised and terrorizing the younger kids. I calmly walked up smirking after he was laying there a bit winded and grabbed my daughter's toy back from the ground beside him. I was around 8 years old on a jumping castle and this random kid bounces over and asks how old I was. After telling him, he immediately started punching me in the face and I ran away. I turned back to see if he had given chase, but instead he jumped off awkwardly and had broken his ankle. I laughed quite hard. I was working the shoe dept at Sears back when I was 18. One day this little shit kid is in there with his unattentive mother. He's running around, knocking stuff over, making a mess. I ask her to keep him in check and she refuses. The kid starts running circles around the register. Well, the register was on a little island in the middle of the dept and had a slide out shelf about waist high to an average person. I'm ringing up an actual customer, so I slide out the shelf and set this person's shoebox on the shelf. Little shit comes flying around the corner and wham. Forehead connects with the shelf in a loud ass crack. He immediately falls backward, blammo right on the floor, and then starts wailing. The mother gives me a dirty look and gathers up her brat, making her way out of the store. The customer and I both watch her go, and then just sort of shrug it off. I used to work in a shop, and we had fake display furniture, so the beds we used to display our sheets and pillows were actually just wooden boxes with headboards attached, and some kid was annoying me shouting and running around dropping pastry all over the floor, and knocking things over, and then he spots one of the fake beds and takes a running jump to land on it. Mayo, the look on his face when he realized it was wooden was hilarious. I felt a bit bad when he started to cry, but there was clear signs saying not to touch the displays, so I guess he got what he deserved. When I was in my mid-teens, a little neighbor girl about 5 to 6 years younger than me came to my door. She accused me of putting my name in her sidewalk. It had recently been done. Except, of course, that wasn't my name in the sidewalk. That not being enough, she then accused me of using a fake name in the sidewalk, so I wouldn't get caught. I asked her why, because that would defeat the purpose, to which she came up with this gem. I'm going to tell my dad you hit me. No such thing had happened. Then she turns to run off, and do just that. Right face first into the sharp stone slash stucco wall, splitting her lips, nose, and cheek open pretty bad. She told her dad I did it. He came to my door and calmly asked me what happened, and I told him. Yeah, that's something she'd do. I'm a part of my school's football team, and, as always, there's one kid where his mom pretty much bought him into the program. Well, this kid thinks he's the best shit since sliced bread. Let it be known he was possibly one of the worst linebackers I have seen in my life. Well, one day this kid says something ashalish to our offensive lineman about his weight. The damn lineman never even talked to this asshole before this point. The asshole goes back to his position with a smug ass look, and the lineman, a guard, this will explain how this matters in this situation. He is the one on the right. Obviously pissed, goes and gets into position without saying a word. Well, the next play was a run into the hole that the guard was in. The linebacker stands back to evaluate the play, which was really his way of pussying out of making a tackle. Well, the lineman took up him as a block and completely threw him face up onto the ground 5-ish yards, 4.572 meters away, and he landed on the ground with an audible clap from his helmet hitting the ground. He stayed on the ground for 10 minutes and got a moderate concussion and a broken rib. Needless to say, he didn't try out the next year. No one misses him. TLDR, entitled bastard makes a fat joke, gets a concussion and broken rib. Anytime you see a kid hurt themselves doing something their parent or parents just finished telling them not to do. Watched a kid slam his finger in a door just minutes after his mother told him to quit messing with it and sit down. I chuckled a little bit. Priceless. Tim was hit by a car and almost died. Broken bones, brain injury, and coma at the age of 9. He missed 2 years of school. When he came back, he joined my class. Mentally he was there, but not. Academically he was fine, but socially he had a hard time making friends. Had an almost non-functioning left arm, tremors, and a slightly different walk. Due to his left leg being shattered, it made him an easy target. One morning before school started, Jeff, who was one of the primary agitators, really lets into him. It was almost 30 something years ago, and I can't remember what set him off, but Tim grabs Jeff's neck with the bad left arm. We found out the grip was just fine, and took his good right and punched him in the face uninterrupted for a good 60 seconds. Being 2 years older gave him a distinct reach advantage. I wish this had an effect on everybody, and they would leave him alone. I remember my 5th grade teacher shutting down class one day and chewing us out about Tim, but it did no good. It was back to normal the next day. Fuck junior high. There's a reason I don't talk to those assholes anymore. Back in high school, there was this kid Andrew. He had Asperger's. He was a cool kid though. I used to talk Pokemon with him in art class. Anyway, one day after class, one of the football kids was being a prick and blocking Andrew from walking down the hall. He kept stopping right in front of him and making Andrew slam into his back. Right as I was about to say something, the football kid stopped again, and Andrew lurched forward and bit the kid in the neck. The football kid screamed, and Andrew took off running down the hall. I laughed my ass off for days at that one. I grew up in a really small town where all of us kids went to school together, K-12, unless you went to the parochial school. All through elementary school, this girl who lived down the street from me was a total bitch. She was taller than most of the boys, and would bully anybody she felt was beneath her. One day, coming home on the bus, she was picking on this boy in my grade. We were a year younger than her. He wasn't an albino, but pretty damn close. White hair, really pale skin, thick glasses. And his parents saddled him with the name Clarence. Kid just couldn't catch a break. Anyway, this girl was leaning over the back of her seat and in his face the whole ride home, calling him names, making fun of his glasses, clothes, etc. A few of us tried to get her to stop, but she was relentless. Poor Clarence just sat there, his face getting redder and redder, the occasional tear sliding down his face. When the bus came to his stop, he slid to the end of the bench seat, calmly stood up, and turned to her. Then faster than anybody could even take a breath, he hauled off and did a full arm swing and smacked her in the face with his lunchbox. his metal lunchbox. Then he just turned into the aisle and slowly walked off the bus. They say when an EOD has a bad day, he turns into pink mist. Her nose had a bad day. She spent the next 3 months with varying degrees of black eyes as a result of the initial injury and subsequent surgeries to repair her nose. That was the last time she bullied anyone. And the best part of the whole story is that Clarence never got in trouble for it. I had an answer to a similar thread that I think works here, so I'll just copy paste. When I was working at an airsoft field, we had parties come in all the time. One party, the birthday kid was being a total dick to his friends, shooting really close, not calling hits, and yelling that he hit people when he never did. So me and my coworker had had enough of this kid being a dick, so we decided to let the boss son play. He's really competitive, doesn't really know how to take it easy, but on the opposite team. We told him to be really tough on the birthday kid for a game or two to teach him a little lesson. However, the boss son just went nuts after the birthday kid shot him in the back of the head really close. Typically, you tell someone to surrender, and they just go back to respawn. Needless to say, the boss son get really pissed, and just let the kid up point blank, full auto. The birthday kid started bawling, and the party left early. My boss just asked if he was being a pounds, little bastard, and when we said yes he just shrugged. None of us gave a damn. A guy who used to pick on me real mercilessly in high school got busted for selling crack in the high school parking lot. Senior year. Far as I know he's still in prison, since he was over 18. Held back a few times, at the time of the arrest. Right out of high school into prison? Probably a bit harsh, but some would say he got what he deserved.